If you're selling on Shopify and you are not upselling and recommending products, it's safe to say that you're leaving 10 to 20% of profit on the table. So how do we go about upselling products and upselling the right products? Well, there's a right way to do it and there's a wrong way to do it. If you do it the right way, you can take advantage of that upside, but if you do it the wrong way, you might end up blowing a sale. It's important that we recommend the right products at the right price point and we recommend them at the right time. So today we're going to take a look at the Bold product upsell app. I'm going to run through a brief tutorial on how to get this app set up, how you can do so quickly, and how you can use this app to start earning more on Shopify. Now, I always like to take a look at what apps have to offer in the Shopify App Store. The Bold Upsell app showcases a few of its features here with the upsell and cross-sell anywhere, and also the funnels that they offer, which is a really nice feature for upselling and cross-selling people later down the road. And if you don't know much about funnels, it is a tool that you should absolutely use if you're doing e-commerce, and it's great that the Bold Upsell app kind of offers this tool. Now let's take a quick look at their pricing. They do offer a 14-day free trial, and then from there you can kind of choose from the starter plan or the plus plan depending on how many upsells you want to have per month. And there's also some higher end plans if you're really operating a robust Shopify store. So let's go ahead and install this app, and I'm going to show you guys how to get started with the setup so that we can go ahead and start upselling our customers' products and increasing our sales on our Shopify store. Now that the app has been installed, we can check here in the dashboard and look at a couple of different tracking metrics that we're going to want to look at. And because this is a new app, I don't currently have any upsells, views, add to carts to track. But you can see here what exactly we're going to look at as soon as we do start to have some data. And we're going to want to pay very close attention to this because this is, you know, the metrics that we want to go off of when we're deciding which upsell offers to continue with, which ones to abandon, and how to move forward. But if we go in here to create offer under offers, this is where we're going to get started with our very first upsell offer. And I'm going to show you guys exactly how to do this so that we can test it out. So first of all, we want to give it a name. And currently I have a smart flare combo LED that I'm going to be upselling with a swivel clip. It's essentially just a smaller flashlight that I want to see if I can get people to add on to their purchase, and it's a good price point, so I think I can get people to do it. So I'm going to call this the swivel clip, and you can name yours really whatever you want to. It's not that important. It's only for your for you to know and for you to remember. So then we want to set a trigger of when to upsell these items, and we can either upsell them on the add to cart page or before checkout. So I like before checkout. Add to cart seems a little bit early for me. I want to make sure that my customers gotten a little bit further along so that I don't scare them off too soon in the process. And then the product that I want to trigger is going to be the product that I'm adding this upsell offer to. So I'm going to hit select products right here, and we have a drop down list of my two products. It's a two product store right now, so we're going to add the smart flare combo LED, and this is the product. So as soon as someone essentially has added one of these to their cart and is proceeding to the checkout, we're going to go ahead and display this upsell offer, and then we can go down here and set what the upsell offer is. So don't miss our swivel clip offer, and this is just to get their attention. The swivel clip comes in handy in many situations, and you know, we can really just say anything here to catch their attention, and we probably want to put a little bit more time into it, but you get the point. It's just something here to sell them as to why they also need this product, and we might want to advertise something about how this is, you know, useful in cases, something that's related to their current product. So let's also pull up select products here and then choose the swivel clip, add that, continue. And now we can select a couple different conditions such as a date range and the cart value. I don't like to change anything with the date range. Cart value, sometimes you can add a maximum or a minimum cart value. So you're only displaying this offer maybe if someone has, let's say, $60 in their cart. They might be more likely to go ahead and purchase an upsell if they're already spending a lot of money. It's something that you might want to test and consider, but personally, I'm just going to upsell based on products. And once I've gone ahead and edited all that, I'm going to hit save offer. And then I can kind of manage offers from in here in this dashboard right here. And just, if I want to turn it on and off, I can do anything I want here to make sure that the status of my offers is exactly how I want it. Now, as I mentioned earlier, you can track all of your statistics from the dashboard. And one thing that I recommend doing is setting up multiple offers and then doing some split testing to see which are your highest performing offers, and then only moving forward with your higher performers. You have an ability to set up a bunch of different offers, so it makes sense to kind of test a couple different variants and see what's working best from you, and then going forward with only those offers. So if you enjoy this app, if you like using it, Bold actually offers quite a few different apps, and they have a couple add-ons that you can also use if you want to offer upsells on the checkout page. If you want to offer some funnels, you can do all those with the upsell app if you add on certain other apps to this app. And a lot of those can be helpful. If you're selling enough on Shopify, then it makes sense to go ahead and add those add-ons, because they are going to increase your conversions and add more sales, add more profit to your bottom line.